According to reports, armed bandits made their way into the institutions on Thursday evening, making off with valuables and equipment from the Sarah Simmons and Castries Comprehensive Secondary Schools. CCSS Principal Marva Daniel reveals that the break-in put a damper on the school's graduation plans.
Thursday evening, the last thing one expected was to be greeted by individuals who came to do damage, to destroy, to steal from us, and worse yet, armed, as reported by our night security staff. I had to deal with shaken men who felt that they were not secure enough to be on compound, and thankfully nobody was hurt, although we have minor repairs to attend to at the end of this event or incident. I'm just grateful that we do feel the support of everyone concerned. The night security, although shaken by this incident, they do feel supported by the administration team and of course the police, who gave them numbers to call should anything like this happen again. So I'm really happy that that we are spared, that lives were not, you know, were not taken, and that persons are ready to move on and more vigilant than ever.
Daniel reveals that lessons have been learned from the incidents, and the institution is doing what is necessary to mitigate future instances of a similar nature.
So with every opportunity, good or bad, we learn from these experiences and see how we can strengthen existing, you know, structures to make school life better. So this was our experience on Thursday evening. We reached out to Cyrus Simmons, our neighboring school, who was not as lucky, and I'm certain that the media has covered this story and have been informed of the great loss that Cyrus Simmons, you know, was unfortunately victim of. So we again continue to pray, and pray more for those individuals who are insensitive. We have a society where a lot of persons seem not to understand that these services offered to children especially are needed, and the least of all places that should of course be trespassed and burgled to in any manner or any form. We thank again the ministry officials. Dr. Meyer was very supportive, called and was very concerned about our safety and our mental state of mind. So we thank her. We thank the parents who called. We thank the parents who were very supportive at graduation and realized that we had hardly slept. So the quality of delivery by all persons engaged at graduation, you know, may have been a lot less than normal, but I think persons understood. So thank you, everybody, for reaching out to us.
Calls continue to echo for the strengthening of security within the island's education sector as a means of mitigating and altogether preventing break-ins. This latest incident is the fourth school break-in for 2022. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.